Good day, everybody. I'm going today talk about the traits of the Necromancer in Guild Wars 2. Yes. A Necromancer expands on conditioning, and that is his main thing. His weakness is toughness. One of his advances is vitality. So that's about what you're gonna need to know. Okay, we're gonna open up the hero panel with button H. Okay, here we have it, and you got some options here. When you open the hero panel up, you get the equipment as first. The second is the skills and traits. The third is my story. Fourth is for crafting, and the fifth option is achievements. Now we're gonna for the second options. Heb je de slot skills. De first option is de weapon skills. En dan de slot skills. They are here. De weapon skills are here. These are the slot skills, I mean. And the third option is the trait. Now, as I said, vitality is a prey. It's an expanding for Necromancer. So you don't really need to push up the vitality. What is handy although is that with the vitality trait there comes healing too. So a little bit of trade points in the vitality one, the blood magic, is I think necessary to get the necessary healing all the way among when you're playing. I filled 10 trade points in. Trade points you get when you level. When you can level up, you get a trade point. You also get a skill point, which you can use to buy skills, but you also get a trade point. Yes, that's about it. The first blood magic trade skill is full of life. Gain 5 seconds of regeneration when your health reaches 90%. There is a deadly second cooldown on it. And the first major slot which I used on blood magic is vampiric precision, 7 health whenever you critical hit. So you get health when you critical hit, and that's number 5 of the major slots. Kijk, look, you can change them here, see, by pushing, by clicking on it. Now, what I wanted to say is what is needed for a necromancer to be a good necromancer. At first, a necromancer is, if you compare it to the other classes in Guild Wars 2, a little weak. So, you need toughness. And toughness is placed under a trait. Under the trade part, death magic. I filled this one whole to 27 already, so I have 270 toughness points plus. Also on death magic is the increase of the boon duration. Now boons are effects you do on a mob, on an enemy, and the boons you get yourself to heal, to protect, to and from your enemies, of course, when you get boons on you that hurt you. Well, that magic, I feel this 250 toughness and 27 increases boon duration by 27%. The first one you get when you put 5 points in that magic is summon and jack horror when you kill a foe that circle on cooldown. Now a jack horror does bleeding, we know that from Guild Wars 1. So that's nice. Reanimator is it called. The second one I choose is Ritual of Protection. That is number 4 in the first major trade slot. Wells apply protection for 3 seconds when cast. Well, a necromancer applies wells, if you like that. And the wells die you apply in the game protect you for 3 seconds. The second major trade slot is that I choose is Crater Marks. That's number 2. Increases area of marks and marks become unblockable. Marks is another word of wells or ground effects that you do on the ground. And nou ja, it increases the area of marks, so the effectiveness of the marks is going up, and marks become unblockable, so enemies can't block it. And now we go over to the second one. What does a necromancer need more? He is, from himself, he is a little weak. So as you cast, you fill up the power which is in the first trade class, and that is Spite. Increases power, I put already 25 trade points in it. Increase power by 250 plus 250. And the other one that also is in the spite area is increases condition duration. So we have increase of boon time, increase of toughness, increase of power, and increase of condition duration, which you apply all the time. My condition duration is upward with 25% after I put 25 trade points in it. Now the first major trade skill that I choose is Spite for Removal. When you kill a foe, you lose 3 conditions. This effect can only trigger once every 10 seconds. So if you kill more than one foe in between the 10 seconds, it will not trigger. But when you kill a foe and after 10 seconds you kill another foe, then you lose 3 conditions again. The second major trade slot skill is Training of the Master. Minion damage is increased by 30. And that's what I choose. And then you have the little ones too. Parasitic Bond is the first automatic kill you get. Gain life whenever you kill something. The second one is Dead into Life. 5% of power is given as a bonus to healing. And a third one is gain might when hit and under 25 health. So your might is building up when you get hit and you have less than 25 health. But that magic is summon a Jack Horror whenever you kill a foe, 30 second cooldown. Gain 20 toughness for each minder under your control is the second one, protection of the horde. And deadly strength, 5% of toughness is given as a bonus to power. So 5% of the bonus from the 250. That's about 13%. 13 points is coming to power, so that it increases the power by about 13, and then you get 263 points of power. Okay, that was it for today. Thank you very much and goodbye.